What's up, YouTube? Here to talk again about OTFs. I'm going to try to go through this quickly and be a little bit more organized here. So again, the whole purpose of why I even post stuff is to talk about the combative applicability of tools or products that are out there. So in order for a person that that studies that to do that, you kind of want to have a sense of the overall quality, the brands, where you can get them, etc. And you know, would you buy from them again? What do you think of the quality? So again, this is all about doing what's legal and appropriate and having a strategy that you know will work, that will help you to survive pre, during, and post conflict. Pre-conflict, you want to avoid the situation, be smart, de-escalate. You know, violence is the last thing you want to get involved in, even if you're in the right. But then if you do happen to be in the middle of the conflict, you want to be effective, efficient, you want to be appropriate to the use of force that's required. Because after the conflict, you know, unless you're some type of full-time assassin or a criminal, you're probably going to be involved in some type of legal aftermath, and you want to win and be successful in that as well. So this holistic view for the whole self-defense scenario is where I'm coming from. So that being said, I'm all about the budget knives now. That's the space that I've been into. I'm not looking to spend a whole lot of money on one particular knife. As you can see here, probably for the cost of one particular knife, I was able to experiment with various budget knives. And I say budget, I mean pretty much under $50. And okay, so I'm going to talk about this in terms of brands, sellers I found online, customer service, and quality, and then ultimately would I buy these types of knives or go back to these particular sellers again, yes or no. So I grouped this, these are the knives pretty much that fit the bill in terms of what I'm looking for. The brands are, these three are Titans, you know, Titans, and then this is an unknown Chinese one, but I can tell you, but I got that from PerryKnifeWorks.com. So you might ask me, what about Lightning? Well, the reason I didn't go with a Lightning is because on the Lightnings, they've got that clip issue, you know, they only have two screws here, and then it wobbles over time, you know, and all these things are going to break down over time, but I want something that's going to break down later rather than sooner. But the Lightnings have a clip that wobbles. They don't give you this glass breaker impact. It's solid aluminum. You don't have this grip tape here. So for the same price, if you look at Lightnings versus Titans, I believe this is the better buy. You got a solid clip. You got this impact weapon, and you know basically the functionality is just as good according to other people's reviews. So that's why I didn't buy any Lightnings. I figured for the same money, I'd go with the Titans. This group here is basically I probably wouldn't buy these again now that I've experienced them. This is a Midtech. It's a seller, and it's also, I guess, their brand, Midtech. And then this is an unknown, this might be a, what do you call it? I'll get back to you when it comes to me, but this I got from Midtech, and this I got from Perry Knife Works. And then these I got from Direct Knife Sales. Okay, these are what they call minis. Minis are, you know, they're not really a part of the combative application, but I just wanted to see, what are these minis like? You know, they're just a tiny, like 1.9 or, I don't know, 1.75 inch blade. This is one I got from my wife, but doesn't seem too interested, so I put it over here. I would definitely buy these again and explore more of these based on color, based on blade shape. These, they're just too heavy. Okay, they're heavy. This one from Midtech, the blade just wasn't sharp enough. I thought it was, but you know, I guess I was trying to, you know, be generous. It wasn't really that sharp. Can you get it sharp? Yes, I think so. It's 440C. I should be able to sharpen it. So I haven't gotten to it yet. Everything about this, it's heavy. That's the bottom line. I didn't like the fact that this knife wasn't sharp. I got to work on it. And also their customer service, I would say, is probably, you know, on a scale of 1 to 5, 5 being the best, I'd probably give them, you know, a 2. Perry Knife Works. They don't say much, haven't spoken much, but they deliver, they're on time, they give you tracking, they treat you like, you know, the way you want to be treated. As far as Direct Knife Sales and Midtech, I'm not so sure. You know, they can talk to me all they want, email, but in the end, they need to deliver. They need to deliver the product, they need to have the product, and they need to be upfront with me. So far, the big winner on that is Perry Knife Works. I did mention Blade Ops before. I don't have that knife here. I didn't get an auto from them because they didn't sell the budgets, but I guess I'd give a Blade Ops a kudos because they're at least willing to engage and sell. Some other companies out there, like, you know, Grindworks, Blade HQ, etc., they've got this. I don't think they understand the law, okay? So as a result of not understanding the law, they're just not going to sell to certain states, okay? These companies that I just mentioned will. Maybe they're ignorant of the law, or maybe they know the law. I think they know the law, and I'm not going to mention the particular states, but if you got your website set up that you can't ship to certain states, and it's debatable, you know, then these some companies will stick by their right for the citizen to procure, and some of them will just say, I don't care. So those companies that say, I don't care, I don't deal with them. I don't want to deal with them, you know, unless I have to, okay? Unless I have to, they only have, they have a good product and a good deal, but you can't get any autos from them. All right, so that's it on the brands and the sellers and the customer service. Now, quality. Again, these guys are the winners on quality again, and I'll tell you why in a second. Not too sharp. This is a Midtech, heavy. Price is good, about $50. This was from Perry Knife Works. And let me pause for a moment and see if I can get that brand for you. All right, this was a Delta Force. Okay, and the reason I probably wouldn't get this again is that I really wanted this double action, and I wanted to get the straight edge, but it came with the serrated. Sharp as ever. It's just heavy, number one, and number two, the spring isn't as strong in here. This has a solid spring, but again, it's heavy, so I won't get it again now that I know what it's like. Spent $50 to kind of just get the feel of it. This guy here, the spring's not as strong. Case in point. Okay, see? I gave it a little momentum as I pushed the button. Now, let's see. Well, can't do it now, but right there. Gave enough speed and momentum that it's kind of screwed up. You know, I'm going forward and pushing the, while I'm pushing the button, the blade's trying to eject, but I'm giving it momentum. It, you know, it didn't get a full deployment. It's not a big deal. I mean, I just wouldn't get it again because I got my double action or my double bladed needs fulfilled with this guy right here. All right, so this is my latest acquisition. It just came in the mail today. This is, again, a Titan. It's yellow. Sharp, okay, and it's the double action I wanted. Unfortunately, it's not here in the on the face of the panel for true ambidextrous, but you know what, so what. I like these guys because they're light, okay? They're lighter than all these other ones. They're not as light as some other knives I've been carrying before I got into this, but they're light out of the whole bunch. Heavy, you know, 7 or 8 ounces. Maybe these are under 5 ounces, I'd say. Maybe they're like maybe 4.5, 4.8, whatever. This is probably a little bit more heavier than that, believe it or not, even though it's skinnier. This one I got at Perry Knife Works as well. It's an unknown. And I had to break it in, I guess. I mean, it was jamming up at first. I opened it up. There was some black stuff in there, maybe with some of the paint. But once I got rid of that, this thing hasn't jammed up since. It's sharp. It's nice looking. I think it's actually model to look, you know, a copy type of thing. Okay, I'm not a one of these you know, product aficionados, etc., when it comes to this, but I believe there's a knife out there that might look like this, and it copied it, so to speak. You see a lot more Chinese copies out there, and I guess it's not as bad of a deal as it used to be. I don't know, maybe because the CCP is taking over, who the heck knows. But a good American philosophy is you find something that works, it's a good price, good value, and you buy it, and that's what I got. I don't even know if it's China, it could be Taiwan. All right, so that's why I like these knives. So would be buy these guys again. This one I'd buy again because it's just a nice looking knife and it's functional, okay? Which one would I actually carry? I'd probably carry this most. When I say carry, I mean in a legal capacity because it's lighter. Look how much thicker the blade is. This can probably do a lot of work, you know, because it's got that belly, so to speak. This is just cool looking, kind of stealthy looking, combative looking, you know, etc. This guy here was the first one I ever got. It's a, again, it's a Titan, but it's this one type of blade, which is fine. It's sharp right out of the box. In terms of quality on all of these are 100%. These guys here, the Titans, 100% consistent OTF function. That's my measure of quality. Push the button, it goes out. push it back, it goes in, etc. All right, this guy here is also a Titan. For some reason, it came in at a lower price and came with a sheath, like a dollar. I got this guy at directknifesales.com. Would I get him again? Yes. He's a little bit, he's heavier than these guys here. He's also thinner. Okay, and this is the only one out of the bunch here, except maybe for this guy here. Believe it or not, this is a mini. This is the little blade that has the big handle. Chinese model. Got it at directknifesales.com for about 20 bucks. This guy has no spring. There's no springy sound at all. It's almost like if this were going to be an expensive knife, if there was one, this would be one of them. Why? Because it doesn't have the springy sound, which seems to be what expensive auto OTF knife buyers want. I mean, it has the 440C. I think they all do. The blade comes out solid, fast. Okay, never had this malfunction. I think it's because it's a Titan. It's got the nice grippy stuff here. I do believe all of these things are reversible, because if you take a screw thing, you can loosen this off. This comes out and you put it on this side. So this one, the reason I wouldn't carry it as much is because it's just heavier. I just really like this. I mean, this to me is the ultimate. I wanted a two-sided, lightweight, and it doesn't look like it's all about, you know, combat. I mean, this looks like a work knife, especially in the pocket, the deep pocket carry clip. These all got them. I like the fact that it looks, you know, like it could be a work knife. And in some states, you'd be allowed to carry it as a work knife. In my state, I can only work on it, carry it on my person, on my personal property. So that's the reason why I like this guy, this Titan, better than this guy here. Although this guy seems solid, and I would solid lockup out of all the bunch, I would definitely buy it again if I was, maybe if they had that in yellow, I don't know. Let's see what else I want to talk about. Quality, action. This guy, these are consistent action. It's really this guy that doesn't have the consistent action. And this was, again, I already forgot what I said, but not a consistent action. Weak spring, yeah, as I just did right there. Midtech knives, if they had great customer service, had lighter blades that you knew were definitely sharp, good customer service, I'd probably do business with them again. Perry Knife Works, they just seem like they're on Facebook. I mean, they just seem like they're 100% all business. They know the law, and when they say they have something in stock, they have it. You ship it, you get it. This one came pretty quickly. Let's see what else I want to talk about. I think that's pretty much it. If you got any questions, oh, for the quality, like again, none of these, I didn't stress test any of these. Well, maybe this one, I took this one and maybe this one, and I took a paper towel roll and just did some hammer strike downwards just to see, you know, what would happen. And, you know, obviously, a paper towel roll is not something typically used, but these things, they didn't collapse on me. They went all the way through, etc. Again, all of these knives have wobble in them. They're not 100% tight. And from what I've read again and what I've heard on videos, none of them are. I mean, maybe even if you know, supposedly of the budget ones, the AKC F16 supposedly has a tight lockup. But even then, they're saying with a little jiggle as well. So I didn't feel like spending, you know, a little bit more for that when I got these. And I do like the fact that they have grips. So maybe I still will get it. I don't know, but right now I don't understand why the American models, the ones that are made here, are so much more. Is it because, you know, they're really that much better? Or is it because that's the way the market works, you know? Cheap labor in other companies, you get cheaper products, but you're seeing a lot of reviews right now of these, anything, whether it's knives or cars or anything coming from out of the States, and they're of decent quality. They were crappy quality maybe 20 years ago, 10 years ago, just like the Japanese cars. Everybody thought the Japanese cars were junk. Now all of a sudden, they dominate the market. As for the minis are cool, probably the closest thing to, non-threatening gentleman's OTF. If you're allowed to carry it, you know, you're out to dinner or what have you, somebody wants to borrow your knife to get a threat out, something like this, totally not intimidating at all, kind of neat. Pink's even better for the women, I guess. This thing is just, it just fits in the hand. I'd get this again, I guess. Probably one's enough, but I mean, if it was a good deal, I'd get it. I think I got this for $20, direct knife sales. I won't get these again. If now that I know what I know, I would definitely get any variations of these. The last one I want to get is, I definitely want a double-edged blade, so I got that. I also have, you know, let me just open these up. This is the Tanto. This is another double-edged Tanto as well. Now you can't really see it on the clip here, can you? Slide these babies down a bit. This is a double edge, but not that sharp. It's heavy and not great service. This one's not functionally that great, you know, but you know, if it's a work knife around the house, I guess you can use it. You know, if it gets stuck, who cares? You just have to shake it. See, so I did that with a little thing in. And these guys are, I guess, you know, just fun to have, neat little things that you can put in your pocket. All right, so I covered quality, stress testing, functionality, the blade shapes. I wanted to have one of these. All of these are under 50. This was the one that was 50. Everything else was way below that. This is the Midtech knives. And let's see, the sellers, Perry Knife, Forks.com, gets the thumbs up. Blade Ops too, I guess. I'll give them honorable mention. None of these knives are from there, but Titans, Midtechs, and Unknown Chinese. And I didn't get the Lightning because for the same price, you get this guy, pocket clip, you get this, and you get skateboard paper. All right, YouTube, I'm out.